Hello dear friends, welcome back to the graphics programming in C++. In this session we are going to understand how can we draw a simple circle using a particular color, how can we fill color inside the circle, then how can we make a copy of circle, how can we create a copy of the same circle and how can we put the circle anywhere on the screen. So for that we are going to use getImage and putImage are the two important functions in graphics programming in C++. So as you know, whenever you want to write a graphics program, you must have to include this graphics.h header file, and once you include that header file, you will be able to call the initGraph function, which is used to initialize the graphics. So this function takes three arguments. One is graphics driver, graphic mode, and the path of graphic driver file. So after that, I want to draw a simple circle in a red color. So before drawing circle, I am going to set the color of circle as 4. Then I am going to draw a circle using the circle function. So this function requires three arguments. First two arguments require the point, which will be the center point of the circle. And the third parameter will be the radius of the circle, right? The circle will be drawn like this. So I want to fill color inside the circle. I want to fill a color inside this circle. So before drawing the circle or before filling the actual color into the circle, you must have to specify which fill style you want to fill. You have to specify the fill style that you want to fill inside the circle. So for that, there is a function called setFillStyle. So this function takes two parameters. One is what you want to fill, whether you want to fill a solid color or any pattern. So this first parameter indicates, so what kind of pattern that you want to fill inside the circle. Whenever you want to fill a solid color, you have to specify the solid fill. And then you have to specify the second parameter as a color that you want to use for filling that particular color, right, inside the circle. So then to fill the actual color inside the circle, we have to use flood fill function. Flood fill is a function which again takes three parameters. One is the point. The first two parameters indicate the point inside the circle on which you want to fill a color, and the third parameter is the color code, right? So after this, when I run this program, you will see the output like this. So color is filled inside this circle. Then I want to copy this circle and I want to put this circle on a particular location. So to make a copy of this circle, I can use getImage function. So this getImage function requires a five different parameter. First four parameter indicate the two point, a point from which you want to copy a block of the screen, and the second point indicate the point up to which you want to copy a block, and the fifth parameter is used to specify the variable in which you want to copy the image. To copy image into variable, you have to create a variable of type character far pointer image, and I'm creating the image of 200 characters, right? So to this getImage function, we need to specify the five parameters. So first parameter I'm specifying is 10, second is 10, which indicate a point from which I want to copy a block of screen. I want to copy the block of pixels from 10, 10 to some 90, 90. So this is the portion on which circle is there. So after this, I have to specify the variable on which I want to copy the block. So after this, a image will be copied on this img variable. So this copied block, a copied pixel, I can put on a particular location of the screen. Suppose I want to put that block into 100, 10 on a point 100, 10, and the name of the block that I want to put. So after this, again this put image function, the fourth parameter is how you want to put, whether your copy will be a XOR copy or OR copy. There are so many types of copy. So I'm specifying here the parameter 2 as the last parameter to this put image function. And once I compile and run this application, you will find we have make a copy of this existing circle on 100, 10 point. So again, any number of copies that I can make of this image. So when I again copy this block, when I again use the same function and only changing the point, the same block will be copied again. So like this. So in this way I can make a multiple copies of this circle. But actually what I want to do is, when user is using the arrow keys, right arrow key and up arrow keys, so when user uses the right arrow key, I want to move this block to right side. On x axis I want to move this circle, and when user uses the down arrow key, I want to move this circle on y axis. Okay, so for that, so I need to write some code. So first I need to know the, what is the ASCII code of right arrow key and down arrow key, and I want to check whether user has hit the left route, right arrow key or down arrow key. Right, if user has hit that particular key, then and then only that image should be copied on that particular location. Okay, so once I copy the block, I can clear the device, I can clear the screen by using clear device function, CLEAR, clear device function. So this function will clear the screen. Okay, this function will clear the screen. Okay, nothing will be there on the screen, but image will be there in IMG. So when I use this put image function, and when I again execute the program, you will find your circle is moved on that particular location. So initially the circle we have drawn on 15, 15, I'm using the radius 13, but circle is not there at that location because I have cleared the device, cleared the screen using this clear device function. And when I use the put image function, the circle will be displayed on that particular location, right? So I'm going to put the image according to the user's operation. When user uses the arrow keys, right arrow key and down arrow key, according to that I want to move that particular circle to the particular direction. So first I need to check whether what keys that user has hitted, whether user has hitted a right arrow key or down arrow key. So for that I am writing the infinite loop, that is while one. I want to continuously perform the same operation. I want to move that block continuously to right side or down side. So for that I am writing here the infinite loop, and I am checking whether keyboard key is hitted. So using this kb hit function, I can check whether the keys from the keyboard is hitted. If the keys from the keyboard is hitted, I want to read the key in ch variable. So if this condition is true, it means user has hitted some key. Whatever the key is there, I want to get the key into this ch variable. Using get ch function, I can get the key that is hitted by user. And then I need to check what is the ASCII code of this key. ASCII code of this key, if ch equal to 27, so 27 is what is the 27 is the ASCII code of escape key. and when user hit it, the escape key, I want to exit this block, I want to break this loop, I want to break this loop. So this loop will be terminated when user uses the escape key, right? Then I need to check the ASCII code. I need to check the ASCII code of right arrow key. So ASCII code of right arrow key is 77 and ASCII code of down arrow key is 80. Okay, so ASCII code of right arrow key is 77. So I am going to check whether user hit the right arrow key using this condition. If user hit the right arrow key, I need to put the block that I have copied on a particular location. So I am making copy of this and I am putting the block here. So instead of specifying this constant value, now I am going to declare the two variable here, integer x comma y, and I am going to specify the default value to this variable as 10 comma 10, 10 y equal to 10 and z equal to 10, sorry, x equal to 10 and y equal to 10. Then I am using these values here, x comma y, x comma y. So before I putting the value, I am going to increase the value of x by 5, x by 5, and I am using the value x here. So let's see whether it works or not for the right arrow key. So I am going to compile this program. So there is one error, kb hit is a function. Again, I am compiling this and I am executing this. I am using the right arrow key. So in this way, so continuously that block is copying again and again on screen. So for that you are getting such input. So only right arrow key is working here. No left arrow key and no other key. For no other key, that program will work. So when I hit the escape key, and when I hit the enter, this program will, the loop will be terminated, right? This loop will be terminated. So instead of this put image, so last parameter to the put image function is XOR copy. Instead of that, I am using the one here. So now you can see when I again execute this program. So this is how I can copy the block. Okay, escape, again I'm using the escape. So when I use 0 to this put image function, now we can see. So in this way we can move the blocks. Okay, so these are the different copy operations. Only right key is working now. And when I hit the escape key, I can enter into the program. The loop will be terminated. Right? The same code I can write for down arrow key. So I am making the copy of this block and putting here. So ASCII code for down arrow key is 80. I am checking whether down arrow key is hit yet. And if down arrow key is hit yet, I am going to increase the value of y by 5. Okay, and now I am going to compile the program and I am executing the program. Now with down right arrow key, this circle moves to the x direction, and when I use the down arrow key, the circle moves on y direction or y axis. In this way we can move that particular circle using the right and down arrow key. We have not written the code for left arrow key and up arrow key. Okay, so we can write such code. To exit from this program, I need to use the hit escape key and then enter. Okay, then I can write the same code for left arrow key and right arrow key. Left arrow key and up arrow key. So again I am making the copy of same block. Again I am making the copy of same block. So I don't want here. I want this block here. Okay. So I need to check the ASCII code of left arrow key. So ASCII code of left arrow key is ASCII code of left arrow key is 75. ASCII code of left arrow key is 72. Up arrow key is 72. So I am checking for 72. So once the up arrow key is hitted, what is to be performed? We need to move toward the up direction. So for that, so we need to decrease y by 5, right? And again I am making the copy of same block. And if left arrow key is hitted, if up arrow key is 72, and the ASCII code of left arrow key is 75. So we need to put 75 here, and once the ASCII code is 75, we need to subtract 5 from x-axis. So now we can check. Now we can check here. So this is extra. I am deleting this. I am again saving this program, compiling and executing. Now see. So everything is perfect now. So all the arrow keys are working here. All the arrow keys are working here. Okay, so in this way, so we can write a simple program to make a copy of a block, how to copy a pixel from the screen and how to put that block on a particular location of the screen. Right? I hope you understand. Okay, thank you.